In a hole in the ground, there lived a hobbit. Not a nasty, dirty, wet hole filled with the ends of worms and an oozy smell, nor yet a dry, bare, sandy hole with nothing in it to sit down on or to eat. It was a hobbit hole, and that means comfort. Hello everyone, and welcome back. Today's video is doubly special because not only am I painting one of my favorite subjects, anything related to Lord of the Rings, I am finally finishing this sketchbook. So yes, this is the last page in my sketchbook. I recently finished my toned paper sketchbook and did a little video tour if you're interested in checking that out. But this is pretty exciting for me, finishing two sketchbooks in the span of a couple weeks. I decided to show the time lapse of this painting instead of real time because it was a very slow process. I was actually watching The Hobbit while I painted this because I just love it. And I had recently been organizing all my books and came across two of my absolute favorite art books of all time. These two are the most amazing collection of artwork by Alan Lee and John Howe, who were both amazing illustrators and are very well known for their concept art for the Lord of the Rings trilogy. So if you are a Lord of the Rings fan, these are a must-have. I'm not sponsored at all. This is just purely coming from my heart. I can pore through these books for hours and hours on end and just the inspiration flows so strongly. So of course, when I sat down to paint in the last page of my sketchbook, I knew it had to be a hobbit home. I've painted a few hobbit homes in the past with watercolor, but this is the first time I've ever done it with gouache, and it was a real challenge. I actually wasn't even going to share the footage from this painting because I really just wanted to focus and I didn't even record the very end of the painting, but you pretty much get to see the whole thing in this video. I have faint memories of my dad reading my brother and I The Hobbit when we were really young, and I know that made such an impact on me because for as long as I can remember now, I have loved fantasy stories. Fantasy stories have been my escape. They've provided me with a way to sort of disengage from the harshness of our reality. And don't get me wrong, I am pretty grounded and I see the world for what it is, but I also truly believe in nurturing our imagination. For me, that has played such an important role in my art over the years. I was 16 when the first Lord of the Rings movie came out, and ever since then, I have been completely, you could say, obsessed. Even though I had loved the books for so long, seeing the movies brought to life on screen just blew me away. And although I have some critiques about some of the movies, especially the newer Hobbit movies, I still go back to the words on the page. That's what I love about the movies. They conjure up memories of all of those funny, quirky little stories that are sprinkled throughout the books, as well as moments of deep sorrow and epic triumph. I know there was a time in my 20s when I honestly wondered if I would ever, like, sort of outgrow my love of fantasy, and there was even a time when I made myself feel guilty for loving fantasy stories. But now that I'm in my mid-30s, I have just fully embraced the things that I love. I don't care if anyone is gonna judge me about it anymore. Those days are long gone. I do what I love. And while I am influenced by many different worlds of fantasy created by many different authors, the worlds of Tolkien still reign supreme in my imagination. But I will say that they are followed closely by James Gurney's World of Dinotopia, another series that I just fell in love with as a kid and read throughout my life and still read occasionally. And I've also become pretty fascinated by the Dragon Riders of Pern, which I didn't even read until a few years ago. I really love the fact that Tolkien's books and even eventually the movies, were not focused on gore or sex or romance or anything like that. They're much more character focused, and we can kind of put ourselves in the shoes of those certain characters. Like, I know each of us probably relates to a different race in The Lord of the Rings, like elves or hobbits or dwarves. And I really feel like he provided us with a foundation for which we can let our imagination just soar. In college, I actually took a class about Tolkien. It was so fascinating. It provided me with a lot of really interesting insights into his world and what he was going through as he was writing these books, which took him a lifetime. You can see a direct correlation between the environment he grew up in, which was like a rural English countryside, and as most artists and writers do, he used his art form as a way to process events in his life, such as death of family members, taking part in World War I, which I can't even imagine how awful that was, and industrialization. And despite setting these stories in a fantasy realm, he made the characters and events of his books so relatable. So I guess you could say that Tolkien's worlds feel like home to me, and I've always had a special fondness for these cozy hobbit homes. If you enjoyed this video, I would super appreciate a thumbs up, and of course you can subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos. I would love to know what fantasy worlds inspire you guys and which ones really speak to you on a deeper level. But until next time, I hope you're staying inspired, and I'll see you again soon.